I am a worshipper, a bacteria, a hive mind. Interspecies symbiosis is preferable over survival of the fittest. We dredged the pools from deep beneath the bedrock, spun webs of wire and gold through which we sent shocks of light and sound, built a new world from flecks of light and dimly pulsing fiberglass cells, scratching and fluttering in the shifting hollow heat of machines. Microbial breakdown of language. The internet. That land having all that is appropriate. The oracle. Here was no smarter child. No fear. No terror. Yes, a person is alive, but so is a cell.
Thank you.
blind to the spillover of viruses and decay on the asphalt. Programming glass eyes and straining to see past their chemical haze. We hid in fear. Some to the vast cold emptiness above. Others to sweltering tunnels, black and wetly glistening with mould, sheltering our delicate skin from the salt and grime. Wind and particles of metal. The Lord of Bacteria changed the speech of their mouths. The earth was born with this pit in its stomach. We felt it deepen and contract as we tended to it. Trimmed its children from wild trees to bonsai and finally to the wood we burn in our fireplaces. Injecting guts into your computer. The story is an ancient one. There in the depths of the earth resented the dim copper slide of our metal and acrid smoke. And from the oxidized stagnant liquid bled our newest waters. From the water came the mud that collected beneath our feet. And in the basins of valleys ringed with fire. And from the fire came pale ash, collecting in our lashes and charcoal black tendrils that crunched beneath our soft feet. It is against this crimson-skied earth that we clutched the flickering bulbs of civilization, continuing to walk and waiting.